Agentic AI in education, how it's going to change education, the processes, but maybe also how you start learning and how you start teaching. I'm here with Jacqui Muller. She is the UiPath AI Ambassador of the Year, and I have the honor to talking to you. And we are here at UiPath Forward in Las Vegas. Many people around, a lot of excitement around agentic AI. So let's dive into it. So can you explain more about how agentic AI is going to change education?
So it's very interesting because with the new age of agentic AI, what we're seeing is that there's a bit of a transformation happening where we used to include AI into our processes. And instead of having AI included in our processes, now AI are actually running our processes. Mm-hmm. So to see how that shift in mindset has come about has created a whole new frontier of what we actually see the potential of AI to be. And in the education system specifically, what we're starting to see is people are starting to think about how they can incorporate AI better into their daily life. So they're using generative AI a lot more. They're starting to see what the capability of instructional AI is looking like. Mm-hmm. And now the whole shift is starting to happen of not only IT students or computer science students being equipped or established or even exposed to these kinds of technologies. We're now seeing people from different disciplines as well. So the way that we're now starting to instruct people and to teach people has started to look slightly different because we now need to take a look at what our different types of material need to look like. So we can no longer just jump into the technical perspective. We need to take a step back and actually explain the business value and explain, you know, how to do this from the ground up. That's the first part where we're seeing a lot of change and a lot of innovation coming through. But what we're also starting to see is how people are actually building processes in the universities to start to cater for some of these things. So something we've been focusing on quite a lot at Northwest University is how do we bring together the idea of automatically generating and assessing students on a very individual basis. So we're trying to create that better, more focused experience for each student. Each student, based on their skill set, will be able to get specific questions based to what they can and can't do. We can then use those data points to actually bring back into the system, into the solution, to see what kinds of questions should be asked to kind of help them, you know, go to that next step of learning. And once they've now started to achieve those different steps in the learning, actually then start to create this very holistic environment for them where we can start to track everything from the beginning of when they start the university journey all the way through to the end. And we're starting to see how those processes are coming together as well quite nicely with the use of agentic AI.
So if we look from a perspective, you mainly say the improvement in processes, which is going to impact on one end the teacher.
Yes.
And on the other hand, the student, but more from a process perspective.
Yeah.
And not the learning itself, because learning is something, yeah, in the end, you have to get it into your mind.
Yeah.
But that's not where the real change is going to be. It's more the processes.
It actually is as well. So something that we're starting to see as well is we're starting to bring agentic AI and automation in its entirety into some of our curriculums as well.
Mm-hmm.
So South Africa has recently developed the RPA developer curriculum, which is now seen as one of our national qualification standards. And it's interesting because a lot of universities in the country actually don't have RPA technologies as part of their coursework. So we're starting to bring that in at the moment, and we're starting to get people more involved in, you know, making that transition from traditional developments more into the RPA automation AI space. And I think that's going to be where a lot of our different material that we have put out starts to cover those different levels of automation, starting right from the ground up all the way through to agentic AI.
And especially in this domain, there's less knowledge required. If you have the business knowledge, basically you can be an AI expert.
Exactly.
We have seen it yesterday.
Yeah.
Now, if you look, let's say, to a more detailed example, where are we today and where are we in 12 months from now? So are we there already with the whole process automation, or do we need to wait a couple of months?
I think we have different phases that we're looking at. So phase one at the moment, you know, just having standardized rubrics in, having standardized assessments, that's there. We can already do that. But taking a look at, you know, creating those predictive assessments and creating those assessments out front for each individual journey, I think we're still a bit off there. And I think considering the new evolution of what agentic AI is going to offer us, I think there's going to be a lot of changes in the next 12 months. I think looking at the different technologies that are going to become the forefront of this movement is going to be quite interesting, and it'll be interesting to see how many times this is rebranded before it sticks.
Exciting, especially in education, and you have this great view both from educating about all the UiPath technology, but also see how it can be applied. Jacqui, thanks a lot.
Thank you so much, Ronald.
Thank you here from watching from Las Vegas, from UiPath Forward 7. And thank you for watching, and look forward to seeing you next time.
Thank you.